Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that what is mean by RHCE exam. So the exam code is EX300, RHCE certified engineer. So this examination has a prerequisite of RHCE. So we already completed RHCE examination course details, and all the videos content is covered on a previous videos. So you can refer the previous video to show read all this RHCE content. And after passing off that RHCE, you can read this RHCE examination. And this examination is also the same similar to the RHCE examination, but this has 3.5 hours of hands-on lab and the same marks. The 300 out of 300, you have to get 210 for the pass marks, but this examination has more advanced content, which means that you cannot just go through to the previous content and see that you can just like RHCE, you can just like pass, but RHCE is going to be a little bit difficult. Like the examination attempt percentage on the single attempt, like 40% is only the pass percentage of the RHCE examination. So most of the 70% people, they fail on the single attempt. They have to re-prepare for the examination again. So that's why you have to prepare very, very well. And here it depends on the network services, most of the examination over here. So let's see this. What is the content over here we have to prepare? So for the RHCE examination, so system configuration and management, use networking teaming, like this is the very, very important things, like creating and teaming and bonding in the RHCE 7 with the configuration what they provide on the lab or what they provide on the examination. So if you fail to configure this teaming or the bonding, it means that you fail, because based on this network configuration only the other services depends, and configuring the firewall settings and IPv6 settings, all these is definitely a dependent services on the other services as well. Like example, you have configured a web server, but the network is not properly working, then you cannot access the web server. So the configuration would be waste. In the similar way, they will provide you the to configure the some iSCSI initiator, the iSCSI storage, and they will ask you to mount the iSCSI related storage to the client. Then they will give you the iSCSI initiators and all the details, all the stuff on the examination itself. But if your network is not properly configured, you cannot go to and configure this iSCSI related stuff. So that's why this first section is very, very important, and you have to be very, very sure in configuring and practicing so many times, or else you in my examinations, like in the first attempt, I have failed because I just miss over than a reverse quotation mark while configuring the teaming and bonding. So that's where the teaming and bonding failed. I did not remember exactly what did I mistake on the examination. So that waste of my total preparation time, and I know I attempted all this total examination perfectly, but at end of the configuration file, I just missed some quotation marks or the reverse quotation takes. So that's where the total network teaming and network configuration went off. And in this 3.5 hours, actually, you will not feel that time is not enough. Like if you properly do a configuration step by step immediately as soon as you get into the hands-on lab, so within 3.5 hours you can complete it. But if you just mismatch any configuration, or you are just roaming around any configuration stuff doing there, then 3.5 hours is not enough for the examination. So that's why you have to be very, very perfect in configuring and doing all this stuff. The things over here, it is the configuring the advanced level C Linux and firewall, port forwarding, port labeling, all the stuff or on the firewall, and creating this web server with the SSL certificate and CGI based application deployment and virtual hosting, which means that you can configure the single web server with the multiple websites, the virtual hosting configuration, and DNS server configuration, NFS, so this NFS client configuration, and Samba server configuration, SMB, and SMTP mail server configuration, where they will provide you the SMTP relay agent and you have to configure that client to send some email to the using the email address. So SSH, actually this is very, very easy. Actually this is most of the stuff is already covered on the RHCE itself, but you have to little bit brush up that SSH things, and NTP, and these two topics most of the times they covered in RHCE topic itself, but little bit more over here just configuring the stuff. And here the more advantage is that creating, installing and configuring the MariaDB database, like how you can configure and install this MariaDB instance and launch the database and take the backup and restore and create simple database schema, like how you are creating the tables, insert the data, delete the data, all this stuff, activities is going to be done on this MariaDB session. So this is how we are going to learn from today, so which may be going to be around 60 to 65 videos on these topics to explain entire RHCE examination. So stay tuned, please subscribe to the channel for upcoming RHCE codes content. Stay tuned.